Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can use Field Update through Process Builder in Salesforce. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube, and you can follow my YouTube channel to watch various Salesforce related videos. So now we are logged into Salesforce Lightning Experience. So here I'm going to create a process builder. With the help of that process builder, you will get to know how we can update a particular field using that process builder for a particular object. So whenever you want to create process builder, you need to search process builder in quick find of setup. So from here, I chose process builder. So process builder is an automation tool, so it works whenever you create a record or whenever you update any record. So you can see I already created one process through process builder, which is on contact object. So it shows all existing processes in this list, and last modified date status, it is right now inactive, so it is not in working state. So now if you want to create new process builder, you can click on new. So here you need to mention name of the process, then API name, description, and the process starts when. So I am providing process name as update account record. API name will be update account record. So it is having underscores. Then description, this process updates account record when a record is created, right? So this way you can provide appropriate description related to your process that you're going to create using process builder. Then the process starts when. So here you can see we have three options: a record changes, a platform event message is received, or third one is it's invoked by another process. So right now I am choosing first one, a record changes. So a record changes have two options, either record creation or creation as well as updation. So I'm saving this. So here you can see process builder is showing update account record message. So it is the name of the process. Then here you can see various buttons are available, view all processes. So if you click on this button, you can see all existing processes. If you want to clone your process, then you can click on this button. If you want to edit the properties, you can click on this button. And after implementation, if you want to activate your process builder, so you can click on this button. Now, here you can see a flowchart like design is available where you need to put some things. So here first is object. You have to choose a particular object on which you want to apply this process builder. Then we need to add criteria, then immediate action, and then scheduled action. So I am choosing an object. So object is account. Then here you can see two options are available: record is created, and second one is record is created or edited. So I'm choosing first one. Then in advanced, you can see recursion feature is available. So allow process to evaluate or record multiple times in a single save operation. So if something is changing with the help of this process builder, and if you want to evaluate this again, then you can choose this option as true. Here you can read the help text. So here the message is, when selected, the process can evaluate the same record up to 6 times in a single save operation. The process re-evaluates the record if other automated updates the record within the same save operation. For example, record can be updated via flow, process action, workflow action, or Apex trigger, right? So if you want to do this, you can choose this yes as true. Otherwise, you can leave it as it is. So right now I'm leaving it as unchecked. Now I'm clicking on save. So here you can see we selected account object. Now we need to put a criteria. So if this criteria is true, then only actions will be performed. So I'm going to choose criteria. So here we have three options: condition, formula, and no criteria. So if you choose condition, then you can select particular field. If you choose formula, so here you need to write your formula, custom formula. If that is true, then your process builder will be executed. And third is no criteria, just execute the action. So sometimes you just need to execute, you just need that your action should be performed without matching any criteria. So then you can choose this one. So right now I'm choosing conditions are met. So if I click on this, so it shows all account related fields. So let's say I am choosing account type equals pick list. So it is a pick list. So I am choosing prospect, right? So if account type is account type pick list value is prospect at the time of account record creation, then I want to perform some actions, right? Now, if you want to add multiple conditions, you can click on add row and choose another condition. You can choose and or in between those conditions. You can customize your logic, like if you have three, four conditions and you want to put and or simultaneously, so you can customize them also. So I'm going to demonstrate this in detail in my another videos. So right now I'm choosing this first option and I'm clicking on save. So if account type pick list will be having prospect, then this criteria will be true. Oh, so I need to put criteria name as well. So check account type, right? So you can put relevant criteria name as per the conditions. So here you can see check account type criteria is created. Now I have to add some actions here. So I'm clicking on add action. So my action will be update record because we want to update a particular field. So from record type, I'm selecting select the account record that started the process. Second option is select a related record to the account. So if you want to select any related record, you can choose second option. Otherwise, first is good to go. So I am choosing first option. I'm going to update the record through which this process will be starting. Then we have two options here. If you want to update record that meet all conditions, so you can put some criteria. If you don't want to put any criteria and just want to update a particular field, then you can do so. So here you can see it is showing all available fields. So you can pick a particular field that you want to update. So here, yeah, so if I type a letter, then it shows whole list. You can choose a particular field from here that will be updated automatically. And you can choose a particular value that you want to put in that field, right? So let's say I'm choosing active. It is a pick list and I am choosing yes. So if our account type is prospect, so active field will be having value as yes, right? Now I am clicking on save. So again, it is asking for the name. So update active field and I'm clicking on save. So this way I mentioned immediate action. So whenever I am going to create account record, this criteria will be checked. If it is true, then this field will be updated. So now I am clicking on active. Activate so that this will be available for action. So here you can see now it is activated. If I go to view all processes, so here you can see update account record process is created and its status is active, right? So now we can create account record and we can check whether this process is executing or not. So now I'm going to open my university app. So here we have account tab. So I'm going to create account record. So account name is test process one. Then we need to select the type. So type is prospect, right? I'm not selecting any other value. So we need to check the value of active. So right now active is none. So now I am clicking on save. So a record is created and we need to check what is the current value of active field. So I'm clicking on details, scrolling down. So you can see prospect is the value of type field. If I scroll more, so here you can see active is containing value as yes. So this way on account creation, the criteria was matched and this active field is having value as yes. So this way our process builder is working on account creation. So I hope you understood how we can create simple process builder for field update operation. If you want to watch more process builder related videos, so you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can go to process builder related playlist and there you can see all process builder related videos. I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. Thank you for watching this video.